Hey friends, today has been a lot already. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. I hope you're doing well. I'm sorry that it's an hour late today, but I am here. I am here and I am ready for all of you to go on a new journey of more Penumbra with me. Thanks, babe. Yeah, so we're gonna play more Penumbra Overture, and we're gonna see if maybe we can escape from out from under this iceberg. We're gonna see if we can escape from out from under this iceberg. It's gonna be great. I'm always super upfront with all of you about how things are and what's going on with me. I'm late because I've been pretty much doing nothing but having panic attacks since I woke up today. Like I couldn't sleep last night and I couldn't sleep, and then I woke up and there was just more wrong than when I couldn't sleep last night. And, I'll be okay. Life will go on. But also, it's just been a really... things have been really hard lately. And, I don't know when they'll stop being so hard. But I know that I get through it all better with all of you. The people in my life helped me get through so much that I couldn't get through without them. Like, I couldn't get through a lot of this on my own. And so, well, I don't really want to share all the details on here right now, and I'd rather just, like, move on and play games. Like, I appreciate that I always have all of you. I probably will take at least one longer break today during stream. Not like longer than usual, just like one of the longer end of usual. Will probably happen at least once. Which means we get to try the words on stream experiment one more time. And how exciting will that be? For those of you who don't know, I do have a second a second BRB screen that has mini games on it. We were trying out words with stream or words on stream before, and like hopefully that'll be fun. Hopefully that'll be cool. But hopefully that'll be cool. I'm just getting everything started. Yeah. So Penumbra is a classically spoopy game that we had started before. It's not cozy. It's a spooky game. We're playing a spooky game today during the day. Penumbra is a classically spoopy game where, you're like an explorer who was in the Arctic. And hold on, let me pull up the page. Penumbra. It's like a, a early 2000s horror franchise that's pretty cool. So we're playing the first one. It's a first-person survival horror game emphasizing on survival and problem-solving instead of mindless violence and gore, which I appreciate. Cozy in our pajamas, not cozy in our games. Cozy in our chairs, not cozy in our games. So you have fallen under like an iceberg. Yeah. Always describe it as the game that the Amnesia folks made before Amnesia, and you can see a lot of Penumbra in Amnesia once you've played Penumbra. Like, as somebody who's played the Amnesia games but hadn't played the Penumbra series, or at least I don't remember playing it, awkwardly enough. I don't remember anything before Amnesia from these people. Which feels fitting. But like, we were going to die of hypothermia. We found a hatch. We climbed down the hatch. We are now like 100 feet down under ice. The ladder was broken. We fell the rest of the way. We are now in some like weird abandoned mine thing that's full of like monsters. And there were creepy spider things, but we're luckily past those, I believe, now. Yeah. Penumbra Overture is giving me first Amnesia prototype vibes. Penumbra will not only put players on the edge like never before as they explore ominous and mysterious environments, the unknown waiting behind every corner for them, but the world is detailed both in terms of graphical fidelity and narrative character. Penumbra is a horrific experience that will grip players from its opening thrills to its chilling 3D engine utilizing cutting-edge technology. So, we got this. We got this. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be so good. You were actually around for us playing it the first time we played it before you were around for part of it, babe. So I think that once we start it back up, then you'll recognize it a bit. Yeah, there were the spider thingies, which luckily we got past all of, but like, oof. Also, I'm going to... Yeah, who makes poor life choices? Okay. I just wanted the timer to show up. We're gonna pause it again. Oh, I see the time is spelled wrong. Hold on, let me fix that also. I changed what it said last night. Is this too long? That's too long. Oh? Yeah, Spider George, who makes poor life choices. Agreed. Very poor life choices. There we go. That's what I wanted displayed. The time for the next bonus stream is 6 minutes. There we go. Okay, so I don't remember there being any problem with me being up here for Penumbra, but should be fine. Are we good? Hey, there it goes. Noice. Noice. Oh, game, I'm so glad that you could join us. Yeah, there were some hinky graphic settings. We're all better again. Continue from last save. Yes, please. Okay, right. We have a glow stick now. Then we have this giant machine. There's like a generator that we need to figure out power to. The main generator won't run without its starting motor being powered. Spider haters note, I mean, same though. Okay, so we had found the generator's manual. Congratulations on your purchase of a Type 7 product line. You'll be pleased with your new petrol-driven electrical backup system. Below are highlighted just a few of the added and improved features of a 7G model. Avoid personal wear and tear. Wind-up startup motor has been replaced with a battery-driven unit. Grease in the industrial workplace can be an accident-inducing insurance nightmare, so enjoy the new increased grease control system. Electrical insulation can be expensive to install and maintain, so the economical 7G basic model arrives without it, and so much, much more. Okay, let's see. Clear the area in case of overheating. Connect and confirm secondary flow by turning appropriate valves. Turn on the cooling system to avoid overheating. Release excess steam within pressure, like the safe limits of the pressure. Begin grease flow, ensuring minimal leakage. Turn main valve, confirm primary flow, pull lever, check output. Okay, that all seems super doable. I'm glad that those are there for people like me who would need the little refresher. So everything seems to be plugged in. This blind experiment achieves nothing. Okay. Wow. We're really trying to turn this bad boy by hand. Yeah, no, I'm good. Okay, move, run. Ouch. Hey, Kaz. Space. Clean. Tab, notebook, personal notes, flashlight, glow stick. Right, because our flashlight has limited battery. Hi, Kaz. These things are our save points. I may never get used to that. Okay. Steam? Could be hydraulics, some form of liquid control. Let's see, this probably is the steam release. This is probably grease flow. Symbols worn out. Should work out what it does. Could be the letter I. A symbol for water? Kazzy, much love to you too, friend. I hope you're well today. Okay, let's see. Let me come back here for a second. Connect and confirm secondary flow by turning on appropriate valve. Cooling system. Release excess steam. Main valve. You were ill, but you're feeling better. I'm glad you're feeling better. So I feel like this one's probably the main valve. This one looks like two eyes instead of one eye. So secondary valve, maybe. Cooling system, grease flow, steam is what it feels like. We need to find a battery for it, though. And then there was this pit. We jumped into the pit before, and there was, like, nothing down there. So I'm not super worried about it. Kaz, I hope that you get good sleep. So we are in, like, a mining shaft now. But okay. Let's see. Really did get everything from in here, right? Oh, I do find it very interesting how much we can, like, just scoot things around. There's a part of me that would, like, love to chuck this into the void. Okay. Thanks for being around, Tess. Okay, and this seems to be where the battery would go if we had one. Oh, I forgot we had a pickaxe. Falk! Valk, thank you for gifting 10, giving 16 subs to the community. What? Oh my god, Valk. I did not test. Ironman, Pixie, Jane, Selkie, Key Paladin, Jenny, Crashly,
hey,
Shen.
I think you're really cool.
All
I
sorts
like
of people
you,
got
Mama.
Hit by that. Wow.
Maybe we can hang out or something. Hey, I think you're really cool. I like you a lot. Maybe we can hang out or something.
You're a clown and a
what
fool.
What is happening right now? And we have a hype train. Oh my god. Valk, what the heck? Goodness. Tess, thank you for the sub to the community.
Hey, I think you're really cool. I like you
Babe,
a lot.
Thanks for the sub to
Maybe
Valk.
We can hang out or something. Hey, I think you're really cool. I like you a lot.
Is it Friday Maybe or is it Saturday? I thought it was Saturday. Is it Friday, Valk? Okay, hold on. Grim, thank you for the 100 bits, my friend. I hope you're doing well today. We're about to see a silly amount of hype. I mean, maybe. It's already kind of silly. The hype train literally just started, and you are 27% of the way to level 5.
Look at this snack!
Oh, Tess, thank you for getting me sushi. What? You hacker? Also, I feel the need to refresh the train, the time, because there we go. Because heckery happened, yeah. Because shenanigans happened. You're all hooligans. That's my... Thanks. Jake, you're so sweet. Did y'all find... Like, have all of you seen that hype trains can get over 5 now? Like, 5 is not a cap anymore. I think it's the weirdest damn thing. Hooligans. All of you. Congrats on the gift sub. Enjoy the level by your name and your emotes and your ad-free viewing for the next 30 days or however long you should choose to keep them. I wonder, and then it becomes a boost train? I don't actually think that those are connected. I think that boost trains are a different experiment going on right now. Boost trains are super cool. Also, hi, Sunshine. It's good to see you. Yeah, I wonder what the largest has been so far. Wild. It does actually show an in-channel high record. Once you get past level 5, it'll be like, new record achieved, or whatever. And then every time, it'll like keep track of what the community's record is, which I think is funny. Boost trains are really cool, but I think they're a different experiment. So what boost trains do is, you know how below the shelf on the main page of Twitch, there's a recommended section? Boost trains blast people out to hundreds to even thousands of people's recommended section, depending on how high the train was. I think that boost trains are just like one in however many hype trains could be a boost train or something. I don't actually understand it. I know that our friend Tragic was having that going. You're all hooligans. Also, congrats, because what you did was unlock a stream tomorrow. So I will be... The hype train made it so that tomorrow I'll be streaming for at least 2 hours. Because I'm not running down the timer during the already scheduled strims. You're not a hooligan. The people involved are hooligans. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart, everybody. So, congratulations. Happy pump day. I know that certain people always say happy hump day in the Discord. Happy pump day. Tomorrow, Wednesday, I will be, thanks to your shenanigans, dressing up. I'm gonna costume back up and I'm gonna live my best gas station simulator life, and we'll be trying gas station simulator DLC and seeing what the thing that lives in the sewers under the gas station is, and just being shenanigans. Grim, I'm really glad that your bits worked, because some people aren't able to use bits in the channel anymore. So I'm really happy that you could. I'm one of the channels that bits are being experimented with. I have heard that there is something that lives in the sewers under the gas station, and I just didn't get far enough to find out before. It's okay. I'm just really glad that that worked for you. But it's genuinely been a thing that other people can't do. Oh, yeah, it's probably mobile. Well, thank you for giving me bits from mobile, especially. You're lovely. Okay, you shenanigans. So we're... Oh. I just realized what happened. I was like, I don't remember closing my... Or I don't remember minimizing my game. I didn't. It crashed during the hype. This is fine. Valk, thank you for accepting being a hooligan and the conductor. The game couldn't take the hype. It's true. Y'all are too cool. You wanted to guarantee the train? Thanks, friend. Things have been so weird lately. I'm opening the game back up. Things have been so weird lately. And rough. And, especially after being sick all month last month and everything, like, for so much of last month and being away for so long. It's really great to know that no matter what, I have these people in my life who I consider core people in my life, you know? Everybody in chat right now, Valk, Babe, Grim, like, Sunshine, Tess, all of you are so important to me, and my life would be different without all of you. I feel like we should have done something because we almost got a level 5 hype train. Like, it feels like level 4 was enough that I probably should have done some shenanigans. But the fact that we already got to listen to Justin Trudeau... Yes, Daryl, even when you join chat by screaming like a banshee, I'm just so happy to see you. Yeah, I feel like there should have been some shenanigan. Y'all are gonna... We did get to listen to Justin Trudeau singing about the word moist. And that was a colorful experience also. Aw, Tess, thanks. That's really sweet. So, y'all are gonna get a sad animal fact. In celebration. Don't worry, they're not too sad. This one feels perfect. Pandas don't have a set sleeping area. They just fall asleep wherever they are. My life is just a long series of naps. Look how tired this panda is. My life is just a long series of naps. A mood. A mood. I have a sad animal facts book. That they're all like not really sad, but like a little sad. Like cats can't taste sweet things, and the cat looks so just empty-eyed as it's like, tell me again about ice cream. Tell me your facts, Papa. Okay. You identify as a panda. Good, 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 good. Penumbra? Could we not today? Oh, so I did decide that, I did decide with the games that we were trying to play last night that what I would like to do is I'm probably just going to record playing them and upload them somewhere. There's a bug crawling on something that's just outside of River's reach. How's River handling that? She's looking at me like she wants you to do something about it. She wants you to move the bug within her reach. Oh, I do realize that it says that we are playing. Our ticker says that we are playing Potion Permit, which is just wrong. So we're gonna remove that. Okay, so we just figured out that we can break this fence. Yay! Into the hole you go. When in doubt, push your problems into the void. Nice, Tess. Nice. Let's hope whatever was in this crate survived. It does not seem like it. Oh, nope. There it is. It's a battery. Oh, man. This is a really long way for a battery to drop. Batteries are not actually that sturdy. Especially like 30-year-old batteries. Oh, fuck. I fell into the void. It's okay. We're okay. inventories tab. Okay. So no wonder it sparks at all. Putting the blown fuse back won't solve my problems. Okay, so I need a fuse. Let's do our Stream Rages battle super quick. Since we're never getting out of this room anyway. And then we'll see what happens. Y'all are the best. I don't know if I'll ever be able to express enough how much all of you are the best. Also, I forgot, we're in Greenland. That's what it was. In Penumbra. Number did it again. Okay, we might need to not do anything that causes us to... It's weird because Penumbra is fine with us tabbing out sometimes, but not other times. So we'll see about this. If fate frowns, we all perish. Is such a good line. Okay. Here we go. Into the hole with you. Hoo-cha. Hi, Puds. Puds, how are you? I'm doing a little bit of a struggle today, but I'm hanging out with all of you, and chat's been super lovely. Like, I can't even put into words how lovely I think all of them are. I'm sorry you're also struggling today. That one spark plug looks like it. Or that fuse looks wrong. We're gonna save the game. Just so that if something else happens, we don't have to do it again. Okay. probably just been a power surge. There was. Putting the blown fuse back won't solve my problems. Okay. So now we are down a fuse. Yeah, Puds, I feel that. I feel that real hard. We should find the fuse. We should find a replacement fuse. No. Tess, I just realized something. Before in the other hallway. Okay, hold on. Let's see. In the first area, there were like the killer dog things. And then there was that other hallway that had like the thing stalking around. I don't remember if there are hallway baddies in this area. This is gonna be brutal. I mean, okay. Oh, I guess I just run for it towards the first place that sounds like it might have extra fuses, right? Oh, we can't get high ground on here, which is good because high ground is the only thing that saved us before. I don't like whatever that rattling was. What's this place? We're gonna shut the door behind us. Whoop. No, please shut. Thank you. Okay. This feels like a weapon that I might have more reach with. So, that's fine with me. Emergency procedures. In the event of an emergency, all mine workers are asked to follow the standard emergency procedure detailed in the leaflet provided. Rescue services will already be on their way, and so under no circumstances should employees attempt to aid colleagues themselves or contact the emergency services. This code sheet is provided for us in the extremely unlikely event that you are trapped in the mine with no way in which to signal or otherwise contact emergency crews. In this scenario, you should ensure the stability of the surrounding environment by gently tapping and feeling the rocks. Once you are certain there is no risk of a rock slide, check to see if you have any form of communications device at hand. Attempt to send a distress signal using the code sheet. 3. Should such a device be unavailable or damaged, begin firmly tapping out a message on the wall of the cave. Rescue crews will hear you and arrive promptly to dig you out. Ah, Morse code. Okay. Dash dot dot. Dot dash. Dash dot. Dot. Dot dash dot. I skipped the G. Oh, beef jerky. Says 50 amp fuses, box is empty. damn it. There's a fuse. Oh, batteries. A cot there. Okay. You got the fuse. Radio? Okay, hold on. I just want to check my work. Five. M? Yeah, this doesn't make any sense. Hold on. Is that 5M? There be two letters in the middle of it. Hold on. I mean, I guess I don't know what we're listening to just yet, but it sounds like dot 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 dash dash dot 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 dot. Dot 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 dash 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 dot dot. Okay, so dot 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 is 5. The two dashes would be an M. The three dots would be an O. The three dots and two dashes would be a 2. And then the three dashes and a 2 would be an 8. Is maybe I'm messing up what I think the M and the O are. If it was not an M-O, what else could it be? It could be 7. Those two could be combined, and I'm just hearing too long of a space between them, and that could be a 7. If we're looking for a 4-digit thing, it could be 5728. Let's hang on to that for now. The 12th of January, 1972. Boys, I'd come have a word with you myself. but I've got more important things to do than piss about making sure you're all doing your jobs properly. Now, I know there's a certain amount of camaraderie between the lot of you, playing pranks and jokes on each other. It comes with the territory, and that's fine, so long as you don't add me to your list. God knows you need something to keep you entertained down there. However, you all know full well that Penrose has some very deep-seated issues with his height. So anyone who thought it'd be a good idea to sabotage his generator, then hide all the spare fuses on the top shelf in the storeroom, would quite clearly need his head examined. You get me? In other news, Jones, I want that inventory done yesterday. The rest of you, it's not going to be all fun and games, you hear? On a serious note, another radio's gone missing. You better hope to God that means one of you's lost it, because stealing ain't a pretty word in my book. It's the third one this month, which means the amnesty on coming clean is fast coming to a close. And then there'll be repercussions, got it? Yeah, so ... is 5, ... is 7, ... is 2, and ... is 8. What's strange is, you're all supposed to be working in pairs, so nobody should be able to get their hands on a radio without the other spotting it. When I find out who's responsible, I'm gonna find out how they got away with it so long. And then I'm gonna fling them out into the snow and leave them there. They'll just disappear into the night, just like all those radios. Harvard, lead mine foreman. The spare radio parts don't look spare at all. They don't look like they've been put here recently. Why are they recent? What's this other noise? Okay. So, right? ... is 5, ... is 7, ... is 2, ... is 8. Yeah, that should be right. Okay. Let's head back to the power room. Welcome back, Tess. Okay. So. Finally should be ready, provided that fuse holds out. Okay. So I think it goes 1, 3. Hold on. Notes. Generator manual. One, three. Or no. Secondary flow. Cooling. Steam. Grease. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it goes that, and then I think that's cooling, and then I really hope that this is right. Either the air down here is getting to me or I haven't read those instructions right. Okay. Let's save again just so I don't have to go to those other rooms again. Okay. Let's try this again. Ensure it's clear of equipment and personnel. Connect secondary overflow. Connect and confirm secondary flow. Maybe it's this one first. Let's try this again. Maybe it's okay. Yeah, this looks like a two. So secondary flow, secondary. Okay, two, cool, steam, grease. Valve. Okay. So let's try this again. That's two. This is what I think cooling is. Two, cool. Grease. I think this is grease. I think that's grease. Do you think that's grease or do you think the other one's grease? You know what? No, it's a water drop. I think this one's steam. So let's see. Secondary cooling grease. God, I hope this is grease. I think the water drop is steam. Okay, and then main valve. Please let this be right. Please let this be right. First try, every try, baby. Okay.
Fiery ashes, fuck yeah. Coming to save the motherfucking day, yeah.
Thanks. So bright now. Okay, so We've been over there. Oh shit, it's one of those dogs again.
Good day. Good day, can you hear me? Well, I hope that your ears are working better than your tongue, so that you might use them to listen to my words. You have...
Can I make it so that I can hear him better? No. No.
Turn on the light at the end, beginning, and middle of the tunnel. But some things remain shrouded in darkness. My emergency message, I hope, has helped, but what you need now is through the wall hole to the right of the fence. Go now. There is no time to explain.
Well, there's a wall hole.
In fact, time is one of the few things we have in abundance down here. Well, surprises are spoiled by such catty curiosity.
Find the fence to the right. There should be a hole or perhaps an access point to further in the mines. Where did that dog just go? Oh, he's right there. Oh, as soon as I open this up, he's gonna attack me. Where will I run to? Fuck. I think I'm gonna make a break for those stairs, maybe? So I can have the high ground? Or, ooh, maybe jump up on here and be like, bam! Pow. Okay. Oh, wait. Yeah. Okay, so it was 5, 7. I did translate that right, right? Oh no. Was it 2 or 3? Was it dot dot dash 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 or dash dot 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 dash dash? We'll try both. Okay, so it was 5, 7, 2, 8? No. Okay, so then it was 5, 7, 3, 8. It's gonna come charging at me. I hate doing this, but also I really don't want to die right now, so okay. We managed to get rid of him. Anything up here? No. Didn't love that for us, but you know, here we are. We survived. Please let there not be more of them. Storage and evacuation. Okay. This place is bigger than I thought. I feel like a rat caught in a maze. I hope I have a longer life expectancy. Same. Okay, so we went to power in that little storage closet in Communication Central. So we're gonna go right. Oh, the auxiliary shaft must be where he's talking about. So we're gonna skip all those other places? We're just gonna skip all of this area that's still on my screen. Cause it sounded like he was saying there's a hole to my right.
Something with a great many small holes. We shall be needing to perform some minor demolition work so that we might one day meet again. For this task, we shall require the use of a large, earth-eating metal monster, and that monster is thirsty for juice from the place where things are kept.
I'm sorry, what?
You can call me Red. It's not my name, you understand, but I am sure you will agree it is a name rather similar to a cardigan. Fetching when worn correctly.
Red is really weird. I like Red. Okay. So... oh, shit. I'm definitely a lot fightier in this game than I expected to be. Oh. Please stop crouching. Oh, there's two of them. Great. Usually for me, the road to all things horror is through stealth. What was that? Yeah, I'm glad there wasn't a bunch of fighting either. The fighting mechanic is kind of cool, but I actually think it's just a little bit before its time, so it's kind of clunky. I am super concerned about dogs coming and eating my face. So I don't know if it's entirely ineffective. It does make it less scary when you can fight back. But there are a lot of horror games that do have fighting in them. Like Resident Evil and like a bunch of similar... games, you know? I don't know what the point of up here is. So I should probably stop fucking with it so much. Until I know. Yeah. I'm, on the one hand, yeah, on the other hand, I do feel as though if, we could do nothing about it, but they were so aggro, I would hate to, like, be stuck standing on a box waiting for a dog to leave, you know? Okay, let's check out that auxiliary shaft. Yeah, the rest of the game is definitely still better. Again, I feel like, I feel as though the mechanics of fighting are a little hard. Like, I like that you swing the things around, or like you can prod also. Like, it's cool, but it does feel a bit clunky, and you can't really change the settings to like make it less clunky. And I just feel like there's better technology for it now. Like, I would play a VR remake of this game. Yeah, a good VR port. For sure. Cement mixer. Rusty saw. Rusty enough, I wish I had a tetanus shot. Bleh. Rusty enough, I wish I had a tetanus shot, but sharp enough to saw through wood. Xeno report, 66B, phase 9, anno, 9002, anno domini, 1992, filed by chief attending Xeno officer for the eyes of the leading installation officer only. Leader, unlike the other findings, 66B appears to be manufactured rather than natural origin. So warrants additional interest. And need I say, security. The bulk of substance 63 was discovered only 6 yards from where the artifact 66B was buried, and appears at least in part to consist of a solidified form of 63. With a number of operational... with a number of operable appendages, the artifact emits a low-level light that a seemingly inexhaustible energy supply, or from a seemingly inexhaustible energy supply, suggesting its origin is indeed as was suspected. Of course, the ramifications of this fact are clear, and appropriate measures are already being taken. Progress in becoming enlightened as to the purpose of the device, if indeed it serves a purpose in the traditional sense at all, has been slow. Following protocol to the letter, I assigned my secondary officer to the artifact on phase 7, only for him to go missing the following day. He eventually returned to the site from a previously uncharted area of the mines, presumably having discovered a new route avoiding the cave-ins. At this stage, we can only assume what transpired, since he remains in a state of disorientation. Far be it from me to question the decisions of the elevated caste, but I am struggling to understand the necessity of conducting standard scientific testing in this case. I, of course, have full faith in the ability of the research team put together and sent here by my immediate superior. I simply wonder whether their time might be better employed on the main site. Nevertheless, it is comforting to know that the actions of every member of the organization are carefully choreographed and controlled by those far outranking myself, both in stature and wisdom. And with this in mind, I feel fully justified in filing an official request for further manpower. We have already lost a number of workers to unforeseen events, largely while engaging in studies mentioned earlier, and further investigation of the area calls for volunteers to carry out tasks together, altogether too hazardous in nature to risk the well-being of more elevated organization members. In particular, the tunnel system above the secondary site requires immediate cartography. You're making the scary game as cozy as you can. Yeah, do it. Yeah, you can ask about the thing you think you remember. What's up? Oh, another flare. Okay. We have more battery on our flashlight now, which is really nice. Ooh, there's a top shelf thing. I love being right. I saw the box and knew there was something to jump for. And it's a flare. Come on. Oh no, it's dynamite! Fuck yeah! I mean, we'll take one and try it. Oh, we're heading towards storage right now. I hear something nearby growling. They did say they're highly explosive canisters, so I kind of don't want to murder myself. Okay, so I don't know if I'm doing this in the right order or the wrong order, but I think we're gonna go to storage and then the evacuation room. And we're gonna avoid all those unlabeled areas in between. Let's get the fuck out of here, shall we? can't open this door.
Those holes in my mind are increasingly gaping. You cannot breach the inner sanctum of the place of storing. The entryway is blocked. So what if the squashy material between my ears is squashier than most? I may not be perfect like a hanging picture, but my words are wise and backed up by time. A pox on both your brain cells. Try as I may, you must think that I deceive you with my admittingly cunning ways. As far as my eye has seen, our rocky grave extends, and yet you cast away my hope like you would a puppy freshly rolled in its own feces.
I don't want to.
Your odd sense of morality is better company than I, because now it is all you have left.
Wait, is he abandoning me? I'm not trying to ignore him.
I'm sorry. Sometimes my emotions are like a disobedient pet. Uncontrollable and often rolling in shit. Better safe than sorry,
okay.
They say. But I think we are both sorrier than we are safe. A tunnel lies between a nearby watery cave and the place where things are kept. Take the second right from the closed door, and you will find what you seek.
The second right from the closed door, and you'll find what you seek. Okay, I think we have to go to evacuation. I think. And it's not the second, right? Unless you count the dead end that was just before it. But I feel like we need to go to evacuation. I don't love the whispering. The supplies in this box look military. They couldn't be more than 20 years old. Piercing white light, still not enough to illuminate the whole room. Piece of a ladder. Probably used for loading. Almost looks like some kind of altar. There must be a tunnel leading to the storeroom. It's pretty high though. Draft coming through the dark from a hole up there. All the same, it's hardly inviting. In fact, it's the complete opposite. He's great. I like Red. The man still clutching, still looking for what? Before him lies metal, jutting awkward from the earth. A hatch, a portal, a hole, a door. Unfamiliar text. Who are these figures huddled around? What secrets are hidden behind the faces of men? I felt something that time that I didn't before. I'm sure it was, has always been there, as if a small part of me is still trapped inside the artifact. Oh. Hey, my food that you ordered is actually just outside my front door. I'm gonna go grab it really quick. We're gonna do our stream raid battle. I love you all. I'll be right back. We'll be right back. Hey friends, I am back and it looks like I also received a throne gift during stream. Like it showed up at our door. So I can show you the new notebook that I got. It's going to be my new journal. Because I really need a note-taking system and I want to make a bullet journal. And Anonymous bought me the journal that I wanted to like make my bullet journal. Oh my god, it's gorgeous. It's everything I hoped it would be. It has all these clocks and gears and things on it. Like a leather material. In fact, I think it is leather. Yeah. It looks like real leather, not pleather. But it's so pretty. And then you'll see on the inside that it has all these pages already in it. It's kind of thick, but it is refillable and it has like these slots for like business cards to go in, as well as a pocket. And it ties shut. It ties shut with a dangling charm on it that is a little clock and a little charm that says be true on it. No test. I love it so much. And then also, this is so cute and it's going to be really helpful. I'm going to make a section for streaming stuff and a section for like, it's going to have four sections, a personal stuff. Okay, so it's going to be like a planner as much as it's going to be anything. But then I already know that within said planner, I'm going to need a place for things that I need to remember for myself, a place that I need for notes for stream and content, a section for the charity and for KomoriCon, and a section for the Portland Online Broadcasters Association. Because I'm making progress on that, but it was a lot more than I thought I was biting off. And then Selkie Skaya, or Saika, also got me a throne gift earlier in the year that goes into this. So I have these really cute pages that I'm going to be inserting into it also that have like birds and plants and things on them that are like list pages, as well as an additional pocket divider and then like colorful colored dividers, so I can have the like main section, personal, streaming, POBA, con bits. So I have five dividers, one for each of those five sections, as well as an additional pocket and other things to go into it. And it also came with, like, these little flaggy flags. So I can flag pages appropriately. So thank you, Sky, for the stuff that I needed for that. And thank you to Anonymous for the journal itself. I'm going to use my, I'm going to use my rainbow pen set. I'm going to like do the main things in pencil and then go over it in like rainbow pen colors and make a bullet journal. And if you guys want to hang out with me for that, then I'll probably do like a crafting stream, bullet journal stream, because I've watched people do that before and it's really fun. And it's really calming. And I might do like a really cozy, like make a bullet journal with me thing. But this is so cool. Thank you so much to whoever bought this for me. It's so cool. Also, the main reason that I got out of my chair arrived is sushi time. We are gonna go back to playing the game at the same time, but Let me. I'm so excited. This is like gonna be the best thing I've eaten since I was in Seattle. And I'm so ready. I'm so sorry for all the wrestling. So it has sushi. We got sushi. We got little cucumber salad because I really like cucumber salads. And we got some miso soup. It's gonna be so delicious and cozy. And perfect in like every way. I'm so excited. I've eaten really weird ever since I've been back because like while I was sick and since then I've pretty much lived off of almost nothing but like top ramen. So this is like the first real food I've had in a very long time. And it's like nothing but serotonin food. So, yay for journal. Yay for sweet, generous beans doing nice things for me. Today's a sushi day for sure. It's so cool. That is everything I hoped it would be and more. Oh, thank you, Tess. Ah. Oh. Like pure serotonin right now. I'm so happy. There's only one sushi option in Treat Stream right now. But I mean, all sorts of sushi make me dance. So right now, oh God, what's it called when it's this kind of roll? If it has a fancy name, I don't know what it is, but it's like a, oh, that's funny. I actually think it's the kind of sushi that D really wanted. I think they're called dragon rolls. It's like tempura shrimp. And veggies, and then it has avocado on the outside and like little crunchy bits and a like sweet chili sauce on it. And then I also have just my favorite fish. All my favorite fish. Though I will say that salmon, like people who have lived here before made fun of me because they were like, are you a pescatarian because you're basically a wild bear? That's fair, babe. Bear druid bunny, I'm on board, yeah. Well, so, babe, is it that you don't like raw fish? Which is perfectly valid. Do you like tempura and do you like shrimp? You might like dragon rolls. Because it's just like veggies and tempura shrimp. And there is technically seaweed in it, but it's less seaweed. Because it's not around the outside, it's around just the inside fillings. And it's disguised by tempura shrimp flavors and other things. So here's what we're gonna do, I think, friend. I know we're trying to play Penumbra. I know we're doing the spooky, spooky things. Excuse me, we're doing all sorts of, like, creepy shenanigans. There we go. But also, while I am... Oh, yeah. Oh, edamame is so good. While we're doing that, and while I eat this sushi that's sitting in front of me, and I actually enjoy it, what we are gonna do is, we're gonna open words on stream so that you all have, nope, stop, hold on. We're gonna do some words on stream so that you have something to do while I eat. Actually, you know what? We're just gonna go to the intermission screen. There we go. That way we can still hang out and I can still chat with you all. But I can actually, like, eat my food. I can even help out since I'm actually here still. Nope, that's not what I meant to do. There we go. Bam. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We got this. Okay. Hold on. Scratch that. Let's try this again. I accidentally cost you all time when I was setting things up. We were gonna fail anyway. It wasn't that you put... Yeah. So, because... Ooh, as all of us fight over journal. I love it. You love to see it. So let's do Lunar. There we go. Thank you. I nearly choked on my food. Thanks, Mari. No, it's perfect. Y'all are rocking this. Y'all are hitting it out of the park, baby. Her hello. Mari, Sober's already there. It won't give it to you because it's already there, honey. Yeah, move it, BB. That's one of the beautiful things about the captioning is that you can move it around. I promise you can move it. I love you. Copper, I'm eating sushi that my beautiful, wonderful mod, Tess, bought me. And so I'm like happy wiggling and eating. But I am here. Thank you for hanging out and playing some words while we do this before we go back to spooky games.
Yeah.
Ooh, that sounds delicious. All of us eating right now is amazing.
Perfect.
D is fake, don't you see? D is a lie. Edamot, hello, welcome in. Cause I'm like, heck, what are these? Maru, you're so good at this. Meow. Isn't, Ekru? Ekru is, a pale yellow. You cheating cheater. Saimi is, I think I'm saying that right. I've only ever read it. It's like a flat topped or like, sort of weird shaped flower cluster where like each branch, like each flower at the end of a branch opens before the flowers below or to the sides of it, and it just sort of like does this weird, like, it's hard to explain. Let me see if I can show you. I had to learn all about, like, botany stuff once before. This is what they look like. This is what a Siamese is. Okay, that was all. Hi, Pyro Dancer! What letter is fake? I think H is fake. H is a lie. Oh yeah, that's fair, Mari. Oh my god, you guys, the fact that I'm able to like eat my lunch and do this and we're all having fun doing this together means so much to me. I'm so like satisfied and happy right now, and like, y'all don't know what the first half of my day or like last night was, but oh boy, did I need this. You have no idea. Hey, okay, this is a new one, friends. There's a missing letter that's hidden and a fake letter. Thanks, Copper. You typed it first, but you put the L and the E differently. You spelled it like Ashley or Harley instead of closely. You know, you didn't add a Lee to the end of the word. You made it like a popular 80s, 90s children's name. No, please don't leave, Mari. You're fine. Okay, so a hidden is another L, and the Q is fake. There's a second L. There's a second L so that they can double up, and the Q is a lie. We got so far. That's the farthest we've gotten on this stream before. Now the early levels are gonna be like a walk in the park. Ooh, I think that the first word is artery, but I'm shoveling sushi into my face. Somebody help. Yeah, what's up, Copper? Oh, I have no idea, Copper. What is underwater in a sandwich and in my stream? Copper! You're such a sweetie. I don't know why that didn't go off just now, but thank you for the 11 months, Copper. Oh my gosh. I don't know what's going on with my bot right now. I'm super sorry. We'll deal with it in a second. Hello, Raiders! We'll get you a proper shout out in a second. Tess, could you do slash and then the words shout out? But like all one word. Just like typed out instead of the SO. Yeah, that was super close. You all did great. Thanks, Tess. Hey, friends. How's it going? We'll do that Stream Raiders battle. It's not gonna be full stream though, as we welcome in this Raider bitch. Hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome. How are all of you? I hope that you're all doing so good. How are you? What were you playing? Let me try to get my bot actually open and running again because it crashed. Your rigatoni you made was super good, and your belly is a happy cabelli. Yeah, belly. I like that. That's funny. I just demolished like a sushi combo that Tesseract bought me. Absolutely demolished. And miso soup. And a cucumber salad. It's been delightful. So we've been playing Words on Stream while I was eating lunch. But we're back, baby. Also, Jasmine, I hope that Ocarina of Time was amazing. Have you played it before, or is this your first time? I know some people just getting into older Legend of Zelda games for the first time right now. Whereas some people, you know, are revisiting faves. What is it for you? I'm glad it was a fun time, though. How far are you in it? And yeah, we were all super close. Jasmine, I really like your very Wind Waker style raid emotes, by the way. You watched your mom play it when you were really young, but it's your first time actually playing through the whole game by yourself. That's amazing. That's wonderful. You just finished the Spirit Temple? Ooh, that's a good place to be, too. Nice. That's awesome. That's super good. There we go. They look really nice. Oh, thanks. No, it's not weird at all. They're actually my headphones, crazy with a K. They're like shockingly cheap earbuds from Amazon that have elf ears as part of them. I love them a lot. I've always said if there was like one body modification surgery that I ever would get, it would probably be getting actual elf ears. But no, I've had these as like costume pieces that aren't headphones before, and people would spend channel points and get me to wear those or other accessories. And then I found these earbuds when I was replacing my old earbuds, and they were cheaper than my old earbuds were too, but they have a pretty decent sound quality. And they're comfortable, and they're elf ears. And so I was like, you know what? Fuck it. My headphones are going to be elf ears from now on. Oh, a new accessory. Thank you for that follow. You're a beautiful nerd. I do keep my follow alerts anonymous. So that people who are anxious or, you know, otherwise don't really want to get called out, can just sort of vibe. You can honk to clear it out. Fair. To be fair, the elfier body modification surgeries are actually existent and people do get those. But you would want to just be able to, like, your way into a clear sinus. You just would want to, like, and then bam, allergies cleared out. Ew. That's fantastic. That's a great idea. Yep, one squeeze for no sneeze. I like it. I like that. Clever. I don't know what's going on with both my bot as well as the game. But. Some shenanigans, I swear, are happening right now. Okay, so I don't really understand what's happening right now, but it says that I'm using 80% of my CPU and 90% of my GPU and 74% of my computer's memory right now. And that's without the game running. Let me figure this out really quick. Hold on. Oh boy. I think that's why the game's been closing, is just because it's like, whoa, buddy, not enough resources. Yeah, I think I'm gonna need to do like a little quick little quick rebooty boot. I don't want to, but I think that I need to. So my friends, I hate to do this, but yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to end stream for a minute, do a quick cheeky little restart of my computer, and then the first thing I'm going to reopen is stream. Okay? So I'll be right back. And I'm sorry about this.